get into your right stance. We have a double front upper, rear knee, front kick, step back, yeah? Just try not to start your combo again until you have landed. Try to kind of push back a little bit quicker before you do the uppers again. Step back. Yeah, you can start punching and land at the same time. Just so long as impact is a grounded kind of impact, yeah? Now here's another kind of technical point. We have a knee, kick, repeater, yeah? All right, so how are you gonna do it? Are you gonna be feet in, kind of like this? Or are you gonna stay with the feet wide so that you have a big grounded stance and lean over? Knee, kick, go back to wide stance and go to the other side. Yeah? So you're constantly going, putting the weight on one leg, going to the other. So, I think I prefer the wider stance as opposed to, going like this. I don't know. I just prefer the wider stance. So I suppose either way is fine, but I go wide. Now, one last point I will make. Remember that the jump kick is on the spot, so it's not going forward. Alternatively, what you could do, you could actually make this a feature for this track. Because this track is quite short, it's only like 2 minutes. Tell everyone to start at the back of the room, and when we're at the jump kick phase, they can just kind of start coming forward. So you can say, right guys, I want you guys to start at the back of the room, and during this track, I want you to bring the fight to me, So you can kind of have a bit of a woo, feature type thing. So you got the front of the class empty and everyone's at the back, and then we just get into it. Bam, 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 bam. And you're coming closer and closer. So it might be a good little thing to do for your launch. It's about trial and error, right? Trying something different to entertain your crew. Give it a go.